Hey guys, my name is Jason with Mount Baker Mining and Metals, and today we're going to run the sample of ferrochrome, and a company from the UK sent us this stuff, and I think this is stuff they skim off their pots. It's kind of a slag product, and there's some silica and there's some ferrous stuff still mixed in there, and they want to crush it up and concentrate out the ferrous and get rid of the silica so that they can have the ferrous and remelt it down into product. So because it's so fine, we're going to run it through our ore system, starting with the conveyor module here, down into the magnetic feeder, up the conveyor belt behind me, into our 16 by 12 hammer mill. Currently it has a 0.8 millimeter slot, so we're going to grind all that stuff up pretty fine. We're going to run it wet to keep the dust down, come down onto the shaker table. The iron and the heavy material is going to come across the shaker table into ports 1, 2, and 3, because we have so much volume that is iron, it's going to be pretty dense. The silica we're going to try and split off with the splitter here, down into the spiral classifier. We're going to dewater the silica and capture that, and then only the very, very fine stuff is going to go into our tailings pond and we can recirculate the water. So let's get it fired up and we'll see how it goes. So here's the results from our ferrosilica test, and there's actually quite a bit of steel in that stuff, or iron I guess. This is the number one, and this is where most of the real fine stuff ended up. But you can see it's pretty much pure iron. This is the number two, and this is where some of the larger pieces ended up. You can see pieces up to maybe the head of a pin or a little bit bigger. But again, there's a lot of steel in this as well, or iron. And it may not look like it, but these two buckets are, they're really heavy there. So there's a lot of weight there. This is our number three. And it was kind of hard to tell on the table where to cut the line with the splitter. But I did my best, and we cut it kind of right between what looked like fresh iron, kind of a more silvery gray, and the silicate I think was a lot dirtier, kind of brown or black. So, and I took a little bit of silicate with the iron on the number three, just so we didn't lose very much iron. But you can see here there's still a significant amount of metal in there. But I think some of this finer material and this darker stuff may be some silicate that, like I say, I took in with the number three just so I could make sure I captured all the iron and a little bit of silicate rather than lose any of the iron into the tailings. So yeah, I think it was a good test. We easily have 50 pounds here. I think we ran somewhere right around 150 or 200 pounds of material. So we're going to bag this up, send it back to the customer, and he can take a look and see what he thinks. So thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.